A very good morning, class. So last week we finished with the first chapter of our secretarial practice, that was secretary. Today we are going to start with the second lesson of our secretarial practice. But before I disclose you all the name of the lesson, just listen to this small video and audio.
बच्चों तू ही दिखाई जाती हिंदुस्तान की किस्मत की से तिलक करो ये धरती है बलिदान की बच्चों तू ही दिखाई जाती हिंदुस्तान की किस्मत की से तिलक करो ये धरती है बलिदान की
So class, this song is a very popular song and it tells us about our country, India. So somewhere before 17th century, that is before, a lot before independence, these are some of the images which represents what all happened before the 17th century and before independence. What was the kind of thing? How was the production done in the country? Before Industrial Revolution, the production was done manually using local resources. The limited capital was needed and often production was all done at home. So as you can see the images, this is related to agriculture wherein people were physically involved. As you can see, animals were used. And everything was done at home. Now, what happened after the end of the 17th century and before the beginning of the 18th century? Correct. Industrial Revolution took place in England in 1760. The Industrial Revolution brought about radical changes in the field of industry and commerce. As you can see, the production was now done on a very large scale with the help of the machines, and that too in anticipation of demand. Local markets turned into regional, national, and international markets. Revolution in transport and other commercial activities were the major effects of Industrial Revolution. So as you can see, class, the very first Industrial Revolution took place in England in 1760. So as you can see, there was Industrial Revolution 1.0, wherein mechanization, steam power, weaving loom, machinery was introduced for the very first time. Later on, it moved on to Industrial Level 2.0 till 19th century. There was mass production, assembly line, development of electrical energy. Later on, then came the Industrial Revolution 3.0. Automation, computers, electronics by 2000. 2017 showed us Industrial Revolution 4.0. There was cyber, physical systems, Internet of Things, network, and that is going on up till now. And because of this corona pandemic, class, we can expect the future world to go digital. As you can see, there was development in transport and communication as well. So what happened after the 17th century or Industrial Revolution? The same slide, you can see the development in the level of technology, in the level of machinery. And as there was introduction of machines, more capital was required and now production could not be done at home. So to meet the new challenges of business and development, joint stock company form of business organization evolved. So class, today we are going to start a second chapter of secretarial practice. And the name of the chapter is nothing but Evolution of Business Organization. And if you listened, I mentioned the name of the particular business organization, that is JSC, Joint Stock Company. But class, today our topic will not be moving on what is a joint stock company. Before the introduction of joint stock company, there were several other business organizations which were developed. So class, the topic of our day today deals with what are the different forms of business organization before joint stock company. So in view of the above given developments which we discussed, there are different types of organizations and we'll be covering all those today one by one. So class, please pay attention when we are moving to the slides further. Now, what comes to your mind when you see these images? Now, I am disclosing some images in front of you. Please look at them very carefully and what word comes to your mind when you see a hairdresser or beauty salon, a florist or a bouquet distributor, the market stalls of vegetables, fruits, coffee shop. Any idea what comes to your mind when I talk of all these words? Be your own boss, correct? The beauty salon is run by a hairdresser or a makeup man or woman who runs their own business, correct? So the managing person over there, the main head over there is one. The idea of the person, the businessman. What about the florist? Same. Coffee shop? Same. A market stall. You must have seen Ready Pay. They sell the fruits, the vegetables on the carts, or they sit along the roadside and they distribute, correct? So can I say all this is can be called as one-man show? All these things are run by a single person individually? Correct. So the very first form of organization where there is one-man show is called as a sole trading concern or sole proprietorship. So basically class, let us see what's the meaning. A sole trading concern is a form of business organization. It is owned, managed and controlled by a single person. It is also called as one-man business. A person who conducts the business is called as a sole trader. So what are the features of a sole trading concern class? There is no separate law or act governing the sole trading concern, but it has to follow all the laws of the land wherein it is running the business. In our case, it will be India. Sole trading concern has only one owner, ek hi banda rehta hai, jo sab kuch manage karta hai. So as you can see, this particular image depicts everything clearly. The capital contributed by the sole trader is very small. There is no division of profit or loss as there is a single owner. The profit hua, to bhi wo enjoy karega. And loss hua, to he will be the one who will bear it. All the decisions of the business are taken by sole trader himself alone. The proprietor or sole trader can ensure maximum business secrecy. The liability of the sole trader is unlimited. Now I'll come to this particular point class. This business does not enjoy a separate legal status. The sole trading concern is not suitable for large scale business operations. So class, there's a word over here, liability. Now you will be learning this particular topic in your accountancy subject class. Usually there are two types of things the business has to manage. One is called as the asset and the other is called as the liability. Now, I'm not going into detail regarding what are assets and what is liability. I will explain you liability in terms of our topic because anyways, you will be learning this concept in detail in your accountancy subject. So class, liability ka matlab hota hai karza, loan, something which you have borrowed. To aapke upar responsibility hai ki aapko usko wapas karna hai, lautana hai. So liability ka matlab hota hai debt in short. There is something on you which you have to return it back. सो आपने बोरो किया हो सकता है, आप पे कर्जा हो सकता है, इट कैन बी अ काइंड ऑफ अ लोन. सो लाइबिलिटी का मतलब है इन केस इफ द सोल ट्रेडर cannot pay off his debts, उसके जो वापस करने हैं, किसी से लोन लिया है, दुकान स्टार्ट करनी थी, पैसा लिया है, तो he has to return the money back. But if he is not in a position, तो कल को अगर उसको उसका घर बेचना पड़े, उसके सामान बेचने पड़े या खुद को भी बेचना पड़े, तो he has to do it. That is the meaning of unlimited. अनलिमिटेड का मतलब है when you are a sole trader, आपका company के चीजें, your company, your business and your profession and your personal life is one and the same. So कल को अगर if you have taken पैसा in order to run your own company or start your own business, but now you're not in a position to give it back, then अगर आपको वो कर्जा चुकाने के लिए खुद को बेचना पड़े, अपना सामान बेचना पड़े, अपने assets बेचने पड़े, you have to do it. That means company comes first, personal later on. तो आपके personal चीजें भी जरूरी नहीं safe है. कल को अगर पैसा नहीं है, if you have to return it back, you have to sell off your personal belongings too. So that is the meaning of liability of the sole trader is unlimited. So I hope class you followed. What is the simple meaning? Tell me. If you are not able to pay off your debts, your loan, your karza, then for that, if personal assets bhi, aapki personal cheeze bhi bechni pade, to aap peeche nahi hat sakte. That is what is the meaning of liability of a sole trader is unlimited. So I hope you all followed the features. It's a very simple answer class. More examples of a sole trader is the grocery shop, जो किराना वाले की दुकान होगी, जो general store होगा आपके building में, आपके locality में, that is an example of a sole trader. All the restaurants, the petrol station, barber shop, as we saw, hairdressing services, gardener services, these are all examples wherein one person is involved. He is responsible for looking after the entire business. That is called as a sole trading concern or sole proprietorship. Now have a look at this class. So, class, you must have listened to this video. It's a very common video, very common ad of a spice called as MDH Masale. And I guess he's the owner of that particular spices. Look at this picture now, class. Bhajan Sons, Bhajan Lal Dairy Farm. Now, those who are staying in Vasai or nearby areas, I know you all must have gone through the highway, apna Western Express Highway. On that road towards Bhiwandi side, if you go, this is a very famous shop and Bhajan Lal ka naam to bahut famous hai, Bhajan Lal and Sons. I hope you all must have seen this dairy. You must have also heard the name of Haldiram. Farsan and Sweets ka bahut famous naam hai apne desh mein iska. Another famous name, Tata's, correct? Now, what do you think, class? Why am I, you know, telling you to listen to the audio, look at these things? Can you tell me, kuch hint mil raha hai aapko? When I told you about Haldiram, Bhajan Lal and Sons, MDH Masale, is it a 2-3 saal purana business? No, it has been conducted from generations. Also, those who are staying in Vasai, you must have heard the name of Patil and Pawar. That is the famous shop for wholesale of kanda batata and lassan. These three main things we get there. So what am I telling you regarding this particular topic and sons, jiske saath juda hota hai, what does this mean? It is nothing but talking about Hindu undivided family. This particular business organization is none other than family business, which is run on, passed on from generations to generation. So class, the next type of business organization is called as joint Hindu family business or Hindu undivided family. When a Hindu undivided family conducts the business inherited by it as per the Hindu law, it is called as a joint Hindu family business. Now, this type of business exists only in India. It is governed by the Hindu Succession Act of 1956. Now, let's have a look at the features. Now, what are the features? Membership in the joint Hindu family business is by birth only. अगर आप उस पर्टिकुलर फैमिली में आपका जन्म होता है, इफ यू आर बोर्न इन दैट पर्टिकुलर फैमिली, ऑटोमेटिकली यू एंटर इनटू द फैमिली बिजनेस का एक लाइन होता है, यू गेट कि हाँ बड़े होके यू कैन गो इनटू दैट फैमिली बिजनेस, सो यू आर कंसिडर्ड एज अ मेंबर ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर बिजनेस. सो ऑटोमेटिकली यू बिकम द मेंबर ऑफ द बिजनेस. एवरी चाइल्ड बोर्न इन द फैमिली बिकम्स द मेंबर. द हेड ऑफ द फैमिली इज कॉल्ड एज कर्ता. The other members of the family are called as co-parsoners. So you have to remember this word. Head ko kya bolte hai? Karta. Bolte na karta dharta. And the other members are called as co-parsoners. The number of members. Now there is no limit on minimum and maximum number of members. Any person who is born in the family, any child who is born in the family automatically becomes the member of the family business. All the family members are engaged in the business. The liability of karta is unlimited and that of co-parsoners is limited. So as you can see in the image, this is the karta and his liability is unlimited. Now what did I explain y'all? If there is any debt, any karza, any loan, then agar in karta ko apni zameen jaidat bhi bechni pade to he has to do it. He doesn't have any option. As far as the co-parsoners, jo baki ke bande hain, unki liability is limited. So kal ko if the karta is not able to pay, then it is not the lookout of the other members ki haan bhai hum apni bhi de denge, apni cheeze bhi de denge, aap bech do. No, their liability is limited. They are not responsible. But yes, the liability of karta is unlimited as he is the head of the family. The karta is the manager, controller and coordinator of the business. Karta being the sole decision maker can take quick decisions. The profit sharing ratio keeps on changing depending upon the births and deaths in the family. So all the profit and losses, whatever the joint Hindu family makes, is distributed amongst the members and it depends upon the births and deaths in the family. So I hope you are clear with the second type of family business organization, that is joint Hindu family business or Hindu undivided family. Just for your knowledge class, I had specified the example of Tata. So you can just have a look. Tata Sons Limited is the bulk shareholder of the Tata group of companies. About 66% of the equity capital of Tata Sons is held by philanthropic trusts endowed by members of the Tata family. Tata Sons is the owner of the Tata name and the Tata trademarks, which are registered in India and several other countries. Tata Sons is the owner of the Tata name and the Tata trademarks, which are registered in India and several other countries. So this is how the family business is being run and passed on from one generation to another. So I hope you all are clear with the two types of business organizations. ये तो छोटा सा trailer है, picture अभी बाकी है मेरे दोस्तों. तो please be with me and listen to all the types very carefully. Now what is all this pictures depict or represent to you? Can you guess the name of the next organization without cheating or without looking into your textbooks? Can you see there are two hands meeting when a deal is done, kuch acha kaam hota hai, then we usually shake hands, correct? So when there are involvement of two or more people joining the business, what can it be called? It is nothing but partnership. That means minimum where there are two people and more than two people, you can call that particular type of business as partnership. So this is the third form of business organization which evolved after sole trading and joint Hindu family business. The business organization which is owned, managed and controlled by two or more persons is called as partnership firm. The owners are called as the partners and the organization is called as a firm. The registration of partnership firm is compulsory in the state of Maharashtra. So if you are running your partnership business in Maharashtra state, then you have to register your firm compulsorily. This form of organization is governed by Indian Partnership Act of 1932. So let's have a look at the features of partnership firm. This business is started by an agreement between two or more persons. So there's an agreement, written agreement, which is done between two or more persons. The number of partners minimum, as I told, is two, and maximum it is 50 for a general business. The liability of partners is unlimited and it is joint and several. That means liability, ab to concept clear ho gaya hoga aapke mind mein. So the liability of all the partners is unlimited. It is joint. That means even if one partner is not able to pay off the debts, all the other partners automatically comes into danger and unke personal assets bhi danger mein aa sakte hain. The capital is contributed by the partners. Partnership firm does not enjoy separate legal status. In partnership firm, the partners cannot transfer their shares without the permission of the other partners. All partners are joint owners as well as joint managers of the business. There is no separation of ownership and management in a partnership firm. As we saw, all the owners are jointly responsible for managing the business. Partners share profit and losses in the agreed ratio as mentioned in partnership deed. Ab ye partnership deed kya hota hai? If you all listen to the first point I told you, there is an agreement. To ek agreement hota hai and it is always advisable to have a written agreement. Aap bol sakte ho ek contract banaya jata hai. So that contract wherein they enter into agreement, they discuss the terms and conditions. That particular agreement, the written agreement, is called as partnership deed. So followed, what is a partnership deed? To usi deed mein profit and loss ka ratio bhi decide ho sakta hai. Maybe it can be equal. Maybe maan lo ek partner lekar aaya 1 lakh and dusra partner lekar aaya 2 lakh. So the profit sharing ratio will be 1:2. So all this is decided in the agreement, which is in written format, is called as the partnership deed. So I hope you all are clear with the third type of business organization. Now I would like to share with you all some examples of partnership firm, jisse aapko topic aur acche se samajh mein aaye. The very first example I'm putting forward before you is Bill Gates and Paul Allen. Now you must be familiar with this person, Bill Gates. He's the owner, the co-founder of the billion-dollar company Microsoft. But he was alone not responsible for doing that. From hacking partners in high school to present-day co-founders of the billion-dollar company Microsoft, their love for computers and strong friendship have led them to their success. Another example I'm sharing with you is Larry Page and Sergey Brin. You must have heard the name of Google. Aajkal hamara teacher, you know, kuch teacher ya sadguru bol sakte ho unko. Kuch bhi problem ho, Google ke paas sare answer hai. So from bickering all the time to present successful day co-founders of Google, they have come a long way. The idea for Google popped in when they worked together on a search project. Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak. Again, a very famous company, Apple, is nothing but the friendship of the technical mind of Steve Wozniak and business foresight of Steve Jobs during a summer job, which led to the world-changing company, Apple. Evan Williams and Wiz Stone, what is their responsible, started as rival in Google and became good friends, which resulted in Twitter. They are the co-founders of Twitter. Bill Hewlett and Dave Packard. I hope you all must have guessed the name of the company, HP. Hewlett Packard, the full form of HP. From being just classmate in Stanford's engineering program to a two-week camping trip, their friendship evolved in the present-day company HP, Hewlett Packard. Continuing, there are still more examples. For your knowledge, I'm just sharing so that you can understand exactly what is a partnership firm. Ben Cohen and Jerry Greenfield, the successful co-founders of Ben and Jerry's Ice Cream, who met during gym classes in high school. They started this famous ice cream brand. Pierre Omidyar and Jeffrey Scholl. Pierre Omidyar and Jeffrey Scholl started as casual acquaintances and later on became the co-founders of eBay. Gordon Murray and Bob Noisy, from rebels to being united to create their own business, Intel. So these are famous names of the company's class, and these are those partners who came and started with the company. William Procter and James Gamble, P&G products, aapne dekha hoga. It was a family that brought Procter and Gamble together. And last but not the least, Jerry Yang and David Filo. Both of them met during Stanford's PhD program and went on to create the company Yahoo. So all the famous names of the companies anywhere started with partnership firm. So I hope, class, the very first three organizations are clear to you all. Moving on to the fourth one, LLP, or you can call it as Limited Liability Partnership. Naam mein meaning hai, liability is limited. Matlab, there is a difference between personal assets and office assets. So LLP has a combination of features of both partnership and joint stock company. Now you know what is a partnership. You don't know what is a joint stock company. But for the time being, just keep in mind company hai, business hai. Theek hai? Abhi ke liye itna yaad rakho. As the name suggests, the partners have limited liability, which means that personal assets of the partners are not attached for paying off the debts of LLP. Kal ko, if you are not able to pay off the debts, pay off the karza which you borrowed, no need to worry. Koi aake aapke personal assets ko hath bhi nahi lagayega. That is what is called as limited liability. Theek hai? Nowadays, this has become a very popular form of business. All limited liability partnerships are governed by LLP Act of 2008. The following are the features of LLP. LLP is a separate legal entity, that is a body corporate. The LLP and the partners are distinct from each other. I told you na farak hai, professional assets and personal assets. The number of partners minimum 2, maximum there is no limit. Whereas normal partnership ke liye maximum is 50 for general business. There is no requirement of minimum capital contribution. It is simple to form, easy to operate. The liability of each partner is limited to his share as written in the agreement. It has low cost of formation. There is no restriction on joining and leaving the LLP, except as stated in the agreement. So any partner can join in and withdraw as and when he wants. Double taxation is avoided. There is no tax on share in profit. So basically, example, agar main bolu to, it is a time-based projects. It is usually for a limited time period. Jaise maan lo, koi construction ka business hai, koi project bana rahe ho, koi ad bana rahe ho, koi film bana rahe ho. So these are all time-related projects. So it can be filmmaking, real estate business, koi building ban rahi hai, developer ke saath, if you are entering into the contract. So it's a time-based project basically. Any medical partnership, accounting and law firms, All those are examples of LLP. That is limited liability partnership. So moving forward with the next and yes, the last topic, khatam nahi hua hai. Okay. So before we move forward, I want you all to show, I personally will show you a video over here. So it's written, click on the play button. Watch the video till the end and read the full text which appears in the end. Okay. So let's see. You must have already seen this particular video many a times. So just let's have a look quickly. So I hope you all have read the text very carefully. If not, then pay attention again. Thanks to the cooperative movement called Amul. So this was a very common ad when we used to have Doordarshan, correct? That time ka ye ad tha. And the next topic hint already mil chuka hai aapko is the fifth type of business organization, cooperative societies. So the very famous example, if I want you all to explain what is a cooperative society, is none other than Amul, a grand success in cooperative sector. Amul, that is Anand Milk Union Limited, formed in 1946, is a dairy cooperative movement in India, which today is jointly owned by some 2.6 million milk producers in Gujarat, India. Amul is based in Anand, Gujarat, and has been a sterling example of a cooperative organization's success in the long term. So what is a cooperative society? A cooperative society is a voluntary association. Willingly people come and form this association to achieve certain economic objectives. The nature of cooperative organization is service-oriented. The registration of a cooperative society is compulsory in the state of Maharashtra under the Maharashtra State Cooperative Societies Act 1960. So basically, this is a voluntary association wherein people come. So Amul, there are many examples. There are cooperative societies, there are cooperative banks, there are cooperative institutions for different sectors. So let's see what are the features. Yes, registration is compulsory. As we saw, if you are in Maharashtra, you have to register under Maharashtra State Cooperative Societies Act 1960. The membership is open to all. There is no discrimination ke Hindus aa sakte, Muslims nahi aa sakte, Christians are not allowed. There is no discrimination. Anybody can become the member of a cooperative society. The minimum people required to start a cooperative society is 10. And maximum, again, there is no limit. The liability of the member in a cooperative society is limited. Again, there is a difference in your personal assets and professional assets. It differs from other forms of organization as the main aim is not maximization of profit, but to provide services to its members. The organization enjoys independent legal status different from its members. So, ek cheez yaad rakhna, if you register your organization, then you become two separate institution. One is your identity is different, your company ka identification is different. अगर आप रजिस्टर नहीं करते हो देन यू आर नॉट डिफरेंट इन आईज ऑफ लॉ. दैट इज व्हाई योर पर्सनल एंड प्रोफेशनल असेट्स आर कंसिडर्ड टू बी सेम. द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज डेमोक्रेटिक इन नेचर. इंडिया इज अ डेमोक्रेसिक कंट्री, करेक्ट? वो फॉर द पीपल, ऑफ द पीपल, बाय द पीपल. So there is equality in voting right. Each one of us has got a right to vote once you become 18 years of age. They follow the principle one member, one vote. Ek member, ek vote dal sakta hai. There is control and supervision by the state government on the working of cooperative organization. So that is the feature and meaning of a cooperative society. For your understanding, there are many more examples. You can have a look over here. There is housing cooperative, there is international cooperative alliance, then there is creative workers cooperative, credit union, building societies association. Example, as I told you, Amul, the producers cooperative society hai, jahan pe it is formed so that the interests of small producers can be protected and unka fayda na uthaya jaye, unko exploit na kiya jaye. They make available raw material, tools and equipments, machinery, etc. They arrange marketing and distribution channels, etc. So the very famous cooperative producers, cooperative societies are APCO, Bayanika, Haryana Handloom, Co-optex. This is for agriculture, National Agriculture Cooperative Marketing Federation of India Limited to help out farmers and agricultural societies. So with this class, all these types of institutions had some advantages and some disadvantages. But the main motto of emerging type of business organization that we are going to learn in this particular chapter is joint stock company. Now today we saw about sole trader, joint Hindu family, partnership. All these types of business organizations proved inadequate to face the challenges which was posed by the changing needs of commerce and industry. So in order to overcome some of the challenges, some of the difficulties which all these types of institutions were not able to meet, a new form of business organization which we called, aajkal tumne suna hoga, corporate world, a new type of business organization was started which was called as joint stock company. Of which, about which, कौन है, क्या है, किस लिए बनी है, we'll be studying in detail in our next lecture. So till then class, I hope you followed today's topic and maybe I was a little bit successful in explaining you all with the help of examples. Still any doubt, you can let me know in the comment section. And yes, if you like the video, please do subscribe to my channel. And also recommend your friends as well if you are benefited by such videos. So I stop here for today's class and thank you so much for listening to me. Take care and stay safe. Thank you so much, class.